Hey, yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays today on Terraform Ladder Edition with a TVP. As we have spawning in the right bottom position, it is the Red Protoss Steel Ghost. And his opponent spawning in the left top position, it is the Blue Terran Alex Usher. Yep, that's right. So, I have still a lot of games to cast, because I played so much in a couple of times. That's exactly the point, and yeah, not too successfully. I'm still not able to dump my bonus pool down to zero, but hey, it's okay. And I guess we could finally see, at least in that game, I had to shake it a little bit, so it's not chronological anymore. How I cast with the date of the games when I played them, because of the space of my hard drive, which is quite full. So I have to pick shorter games now and mix it up a little bit. But that's fine. So yeah, now you will see the new build order. I'm going for a 12 Rex and a 13 SCV. And no gas so far, and that's very special. And this build order is so cool, but so difficult to execute, it's unbelievable. You need totally rely on your scouting. All the timings are so clutch, it's so difficult to hit them, and sometimes it's even impossible. I have no clue. Sometimes, very hard. But now we come to the special thing. We have a typical gateway gas. But no scouts whatsoever for Steel Ghost, and there we go with the engineering block. And the good thing is, the timing of this engineering bay is, yeah, so cool, because most Protoss don't scout that, because it doesn't fit in their build to send out a probe at that time. It's just not typical for Protoss nowadays in the meta to scout at that time. So I can have the engineering bay at 99%, which is so amazing. And behind that, still no gas. The gases will be taken soon. And now he sees it with the probe. Wants to take that. This is perfect for me, because he will take forever to kill this engineering bay. He has to throw down a second gas. He didn't cancel the salad, which was good for him now. But yeah, it takes so long. And behind that, I can expand quite nicely. Yep. One thing I have to think about is, if he's not attacking the engineering bay with the salad at that time, then it's most likely moving across the map and you have to immediately throw down the bunker. This bunker would be way too late. So there we go, 4-minute gas. That's the next part of the build order. So 18 command center and 4-minute double gas. And don't forget to cancel. And now he moves across the map, but that's fine. This SCV, he doesn't see it. Now he sees it. Okay, and I go in again and see, okay. Oh my god, I'm so annoying. I see the Nexus, which is fine, but the bunker will be ready there, and I should be able to deal with that. He's also just now getting the upgrade and a second gateway, because he needs to spend his money somehow. So yeah, it should be fine. The Stalker not doing anything here. There's a Marine in the bunker, so it's fine. Three Marines at the top to deny the Mothership Core. And we are getting the 5-minute factory and the 5:30 a second factory. It should start right now. There we go. And yeah, he will scout it, which is nice, but needs to be so carefully with the Mothership Core. Oh my god, Mr. Taking so much damage. Lucky one, but it's so low. It could be sniped, maybe. Robotics facility behind that. And yeah, he cannot really pressure because of the bunker. And there goes the 6-minute scan. That's the last part of this build order so far. And now I see the robotics is late. And that's great. That's really good for me. Because what I can do now is do a really nice follow-up. And that's exactly what we see here. So this build order I'm playing currently on that game here is, you need to know what your opponent is doing and then react to it. It's a reactive mech style. And with my scan I saw the late robotics facility, which leads me to go for a double reactor factory and a starport and an armory. And the starport will get a reactor as well. Should be, soon. As soon as I got the gas, there we go. And I will go heavy Hellbat and heavy Marine. So I will, later, at the 9-minute mark, I guess, I will move out with everything. And the most important thing is, he will have such a hard time to defend. Because of the Marines, he didn't scout it. Not the starport. And because his robotics is so late, and that's the nice thing, his observer is late. There is his observer. So he will hit at 8:30, which is way too late to react to what's coming. Way too late to properly react to that. So you will see how that goes. Income wise, it's quite equal. So that's fine. I mean, I got mules. Hooray. Yeah, but I skipped some SCVs. As you can see, I'm not producing SCVs currently. I'm skipping SCVs in order to do this two base attack, which is really strong. And now he sees with the observer. Oh god, no. Yeah, now he sees the Hellions. And that's late. It's super late, because sure, he can throw down cannons and he can maybe get down out of Colossus, but he must be worried what's coming. He's throwing down gates, pulling back the Stalker, which is really nice. And he sees, oh yeah, Hellions. And he might not even think about the armory. The good thing is, I'm getting the plating upgrade as well. So that not only helps my Hellbats, but also the Medivacs, which is awesome. So 9-minute move out. Try to avoid the center of the map, which wouldn't be necessary here. And what I wanna do first is check for a third base. If there is a third base, I can cancel it immediately. Because with his units, as you can see, one Zealot, two Stalker, 4 Sentries and a Mothership Core is not enough to defend a third base yet. So he needs to wait. Yeah, now I will spot this base. I should at the 10-minute mark. 9-minute is move out. Transform those Hellions into the Hellbats. And then go in and check for the natural. Load up everything to be able to drop on top of the Protoss army, which can deal so much damage. So, and I really should check. If I didn't, I'm not sure. But I should check for the third first. And there we go. And yeah, he's in a good spot. Defensively speaking. There we go. Force fields are really good. Dropping on top of the sentries. Most of them go down. Really good force fields. And with the single Colossus, he can crank out a lot of damage. But how much damage will he take? That's the big question. Pulling some probes there. Lost 11 workers so far. That's huge. And dropping on top of that army with the Marines again. He's still holding strong. The Nexus Cannon doing its thing. Very good so far. And with the second Colossus, he should be able to hold that. Very nice defense. Very nice. So, that's something. If I wouldn't have lost so horribly with my micro and decision making, I could have straight up killed him. I mean, drop on top of the Colossus, use the Medivacs and drop everything behind the force fields. But behind that, as you can see, I went for a third command center, getting the second armory, I took my gases, which is not saturated properly, and got additional factories. Normally they should be finished now with the tech lab and producing tanks already, because of the counterattack which could come. I mean, there are a bunch of Stalker, a bunch of Colossus, he could pressure hard my base here. But there we go, follow up with drops, and that's the most awesome part of all. Against Twilight it can be difficult to drop, because of Blink Stalker, but against Robotics and Stargate it can be super cool. Look at that, he has to pull back. Those are not Vitamines, those are Hellbats, and Hellbats can kill this cannon. He doesn't get this one, and the other Vitamines, they dealt some damage as well. Now he has to pull back, warping in Zealots against that, second drop coming in, there is a Vitamine with it this time, and splash damage on towards his Hellbat, but he can't move out. He's on the run, left to right. And how many probes died so far? Just 18, which is not too much, but oh, even using the photon overcharge again. So he cleared that drop. Behind that, another drop should be on the way already. That's the thing. I need to work on my multitasking in order to make that happen. But as you can see, worker-wise, I'm now ahead. I got the third base established, it's mining with mules and gas, why it's very important. And I'm cranking out a lot of tanks and some Vikings because of the Stalker and Colossus count. And to be honest, Stalker Colossus is not really good against Mech. So now he sees the next medivac drop, there is a salad and a photon cannon, and he clears that medivac. That's really nice. He might lose another probe here and there. So those drops, sure, it's nice when they do damage, but the most important part for them is to give me the time to max out behind that, to really go mech heavy in order to push out at, 160 supply, something like that. And then I want to have a fourth base on the way to tech to battle cruiser. So that's the game plan. And as you can see, so far, at least in that game, it's working quite well. The most important part, the most difficult part for me is playing against Blink and with early aggression, which is so difficult. There you see, second starport is on the way. And there is another drop here, and this time his army not in position to defend, so he might lose one or two more probes. I really should have gotten a blue flame, but yeah, you can see more probes went down there. Not a huge amount, but still, those drops are annoying. They are dealing damage. They are forcing him to pull worker. And there's another drop here, again with Hellbats. And you can see he has to warp in units. He might not even want to, because Stalker and Zealots are... Charge slots are good against Mech at some point, yes. But Stalker? Not really. And those cannons are also minerals he couldn't spend to go into gateways. So all that you have to take into account. And it's just annoying. Now I can move out. 170 supply. That's perfect. And what you need to do is have a small army back at home at your third base for counter warp-ins. So I would recommend two tanks. One to siege Widow Mines and a couple of Hellbats. Not too much, of course, as Mech is strong if you move out and with all your army. Not like Bio. Bio is stronger when you have small portions of army fighting all over the place. But yeah, this is now Mech. And with that, the Colossus, they aren't that great. I mean, I need to be careful. Oh, the Mothership Core could die here. Will die. Gets a time warp out, but for, not really in a good position. And... now I can siege up the third base, and look at the supply. I mean, I'm ahead like 70 supply, 60 supply. Oh, Widow Mine, huge shot! And yeah, the Archons are good, but the Colossus... ah, he's taking out the tanks, which is nice. So far, not badly played. He cleared all the tanks, but he lost all the Colossus. And he will lose the Immortal. Oh, Blue Flame finally finished. Look at all the probes going down! That's wow. 50 probes in total. Damn. And if you look at the unit lost there, you can see how much he lost there. It's quite equal. Sure. But I guess I just mined way more. Way more. And I can remix. Look at the supply. I mean, he got almost no army left. And I could push again. So with a Hellbat run by, because why not? There's the Widow Mines. He has even to place a cannon there, because where's his observer? He got three observer. One in the main base, one at my base, and one there. But he has chosen to get a cannon at this ramp. And finally he's transitioning. Oh my goodness. Finally he's transitioning into the composition he wants to have against Mech, which is Archon, Charge Lord, Immortal, and High Templar. But at that stage of the game, it's so late, because if you look at the production tab... okay, I'm just now setting up for my battlecruiser. All those Archons derping around because of the SimCity. You might even lose this Immortal to those Hellbats, that wouldn't be very good. Oh! If I could kill all those probes, that would be huge, but instead I'm getting some Zealots here. That's okay. So he has two warp in Zealots again, instead of High Templar, which he couldn't afford anything. Yeah, gas was taken out. He's in a very rough spot. And I can move out again. I mean, sure, I'm way too heavy on Hellions now. But I can trade over and over again. And that's really good. I'm getting Cloak. I really would love to see Battlecruiser being made soon, but I still didn't get a fusion for. There are his Archons. Landing those Vikings, I'm not sure about that. I mean, yes, they are not useful against anything he got. But I could have still have them in the air to take out those observer. There you go. Bye bye. And tanks are sieging up. And there we go. So many hellbats. And with the tank fire, he just can't trade. Even though his units are really good against my composition, it's just the sheer number I got. And with that, that's GG. So this time no battle cruiser, but Banshee behind that instead. Can work as well. I still need to work on my multitasking with the drop so that I hit really the whole time and have tanks in production after the attack failed. So if the attack doesn't work against the robotics facility, the late robotics facility because of the eBay block, then I need to have tanks in production. I need to click the tanks as soon as the attack failed, at least, because then I have three tanks in position to defend here with a lot of hellbats behind that, and that would be awesome. So yeah, that's basically how I'm trying now this build order. It works also on a four player map, but the early game is super difficult. I have real difficulties against, for example, the Mothership Core, Zealot Stalker push, Oracles can be a pain in the butt, Blink of course, Dark Templar, stuff like that. Against Blink it's difficult for me to take a third base. And then it's also difficult because I have tanks and hellbats against Charge Lord, Immortal, Arcanine, Templar, which is not really good for me. So what I'm trying currently is I try to make Speed Widowmine drops on top of the Protoss army to work. But that's also very difficult for me to do so. I need to work on that. I really need to practice that one. It is awesome, but it takes a lot of practice and preparation in order to successfully execute it. So, yeah. There you go, and that was not a Diamond Scrub, this was a Master League player. I don't know how good he was or which rank, I don't remember, but yeah, definitely Master League. So it can work in Master League, and I know there are some people in GM as well who make mech work, so it is possible to play mech against Protoss. It is viable. Maybe it's not as strong as Bio because it's more difficult to deal damage, but it can definitely be a nice way to play against Protoss. So yeah, with that said, thank you for watching, as always. I hope you enjoyed, and I wish you a very nice day, and